Your apartment building is on fire, and thick, choking smoke is everywhere. What should you do? How can you get out alive? The devastating fire in New York City, the worst in the city in nearly four decades, is throwing the spotlight on high-rise apartment building fires. The fire started in an apartment on the third floor after a small electric space heater set a mattress aflame. The family fled, but the front door that was supposed to close automatically remained open, allowing toxic smoke to spread to the upper floors. You can see all those windows smashed out.
The smoke traveled throughout the building, and the smoke is what caused the deaths and the serious injuries.
Survivors of the conflagration ran for their lives down the stairwells, which are fireproof, but were reportedly filled with toxic smoke that was so thick, many victims couldn't see a thing. All they heard were the screams of those trapped. This woman lives on the floor where the fire started.
I was scared to death.
How'd you get out?
I got the butcher knife and cut the screen open and put my head out.
There are lessons to this disaster that we can all learn from, says Assistant Chief James Hickman of the Nassau County Fire Marshal's Office outside New York City.
The best thing for you to do in most modern buildings is to stay where you are in your apartment. That apartment is designed to protect you. If you see smoke coming in, put a towel or a wet towel around the edges of the door so the smoke can't get in.
Space heaters are involved in about 1,700 fires in the United States each year, resulting in some 80 deaths. In this video, the San Diego Fire Department shows what can happen when a curtain comes into contact with a space heater. Experts say you should keep flammable materials at least 3 feet away from space heaters and plug space heaters directly into a wall outlet, never into a power strip.